In the previous episode of Road to Shrimp for Life, we learned that life of a shrimp may consist of getting lit like a bick, unlocking the swag, and letting them know that they should know better. This episode, we move to Shrimp Life 2, see how we can make ourselves more shrimp. I did not like that song. I did like some of the inflections that Slim Jimmy had in that last verse where he went, "The camera," some shit like that. Problem with that one was, it seemed like they was going for the first album, the same vibe as the first album, but you have to realize that the first album dropped in 2015 as this dropped in 2016, so not too far apart, I guess. I did like the engine starting of it and the, just like all the car sampling that one. That was a creative point. But it didn't really hold up to it. Wait until we turn this bitch upside down. What are you doing? Just looking at you up here. She shot me. They feel real. Yeah, she was stay chill. It's for real. You know, like, the only thing that this song was missing was that just where they have the big gap. Actually, this seems, the big gap seems very unpredictable at the same time. But to make it flow better or whatever, I think the only thing that this song was missing was when, like, just when Slim Jimmy at the end says for real. I think the chorus should also end with for real. Telling me slow down. They gave me a chill pill. No, still, I ain't listen to her cause I'm still. Over here cause you a kid clap here. Being game to that girl and her friend. Yeah, the shit stay chill. Yeah. Do you know, that's a song that I do like off that album. So the only thing that I was probably missing was the for real in the chorus. Apart from that, I like the distorted bass that it has. I like all of the people that were on the song did their thing. Obviously Kodak Black, early Kodak Black as well, 2016 Kodak Black. Slim Jimmy had a good verse. Slim Jimmy's like, I hope he has some highlights on the Shrimp for Life. Like, he's so underrated. It could be really great or really bad. Yeah. I think the chorus was creative. The rest of it was kind of basic. It's not so bad that it was. It's not too bad, but it's not great at all. Obviously, the best highlight was the chorus. That was about it. I liked the keys. It could have been great, you know, but it was fun. I'm so far out of sight. Smooth criminal. Michael Jackson, you walking like I pressed the button on the Cupid's goodbye. Don't get no doubt. Don't think I'm in a job. As you can tell, I really do like that song. I think the music video for this song is like the best music videos, one of the best music videos I've ever seen. So that obviously boosts, because music videos help out songs a lot. So this is like a really classic song to me. But y'all remember this one. Black Beatles in the city, you'd be back immediately to confiscate the money. You said flowers, but you said you didn't receive. Girls know me, know me. They lose it when they give me their kickers, the white scribbles, and their real clothes. Your body like a work of art, baby. You know what I do like about that song? I like the structure of that song. I talked about structure. I like how it comes in with this plugs. good intro. That makes sense. It comes with this app. And it's where these tone of voice is correct on this one. I like the high pitch that he went for, and like, I don't remember any high pitch. I guess in Come Gary, he would have had the high pitch vocals, but not in a lot of the songs on Shroom Life 1. But he started like doing it in 2016 for real, and then Swang, he kind of that was the whole thing. Shout out to Juicy J, I Will Wait Till Powerglide, on the next album. But this song, no. This song, no. Yeah! I got appreciation for Lil Jon after all the songs that Lil Jon has done. Slim Jimmy is the Apple the app of Ray Shrimmed, and that song was that had a flat line until after Slim Jimmy's verse, and then the chorus sounded even better. Young nigga, I done came a long way. Came a long way. That sounded like what they were talking about, I guess. It's kind of, you know what I mean? But I like the, I think they call it prophetic fallacy or something shit like that. Where in English that means that the weather matches the tone of whatever story's being told. But in this case, it's like the background music matches the tone of what's being said. Cause like still lit, like thank, I'm grateful that we came this way, but like still emotional with the piano, it's still relaxed, chill, but it wasn't the best song on the year. That was very Drake. Don't feel like this song's gonna be good. I'm gonna skip. This one is not the best at all, is it? That's all right. Man, that could have been so good. I like the, I like what Sway Lee was doing with the hook. It just flatlined. I like that lead. And that sounded very 2016. Still flatline. Like, it's a good job they did put this on the looks. I'm SGYC. You've been awesome, guys. This was Shrem Life 2. I'll rate this a 4. Peace.